want to share with you,
yeah,
and your family,
family,
the love of Jesus Christ,
Jesus Christ.
So tune in,
tune in,
and we will grow together to increase our faith with God.
With one touch in the streets,
we're touching hearts and changing lives.
With one touch in the streets, we're here for you right now.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Thank you so much for coming in to One Touch Ministries, where we are touching hearts and changing lives. God is so good, and He's worthy to be praised. Father, we thank you right now for all that you're doing in this season of our lives. God, we thank you for how you're moving in and about this time, God. We just thank you for what you're doing. We thank you for how you're moving in us, God. We thank you for today's broadcast. God, we thank you for each and everyone that is tuning in right now. Hallelujah. God, we ask you to bless their homes right now. We send the Holy Ghost to their house right now.
Things that we do, that we indulge in, causes our character to be
distorted. It makes people look at us in a different way. We don't mean for it to be distorted, but it happens because we're engaging and indulging in things that are not of God. We are all guilty, leaders included, all guilty of engaging into things that's not of God. Father, we ask you to forgive us right now in the name of Jesus. We are pushing and pulling on heaven today. I just want to quickly bring this out. I love when I go in the store. I'm getting ready to go in the store and the person that's coming out doesn't hold the door for me. You may say, oh, that's being rude. He or she is not being rude. They know what it costs. They know what it costs to pull the door open, to go in one way, and to come out another.
My God.
The reason why they're not holding the door for you is because they want you to experience it all. They want you to experience having to pull the door open, to go in, to get whatever needs to be gotten, get fixed the way you need to get fixed, to push the door open, to walk out.
My God.
So let's not think of people being rude when they don't hold the doors open for us, because they want you to experience. You got to be in the position to say, God, I am willing to experience the transformation. You got to say, God, I'm willing to experience this thing. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
I'm willing to. Hallelujah. I'm willing to experience. Transform you right now. God is transforming you right now. Your spirit is being renewed. He's transforming you right now. It reminds me of the Transformers. They come out as Corvettes, but they come into they come and they form into something else. God said, I'm transforming. God has said, I'm transformation is coming about.
My God.
There's a transformation spirit coming about. It's resting on you right now. In this week, you'll begin to see God doing a transformation in your life. Within this day, you will see God do a transformation in your life. There's a transformation that's about to start. Father, we thank you for the transformation.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Some of you need to say, God, transform me.
Yes, God, transform me.
Just transform me, God. That means God is getting ready to do something what new.
Yes. Come on.
That's why I said I get excited about my next week, because I'm stepping into something what?
New.
Woo! Yes. Shaka! Oh, come on, Pastor. I'm telling you, I'm stepping into something new. I'm telling you, I get excited when I say I'm excited about my next, because why? I am transferring into something what? New. Shaka! I got two. Hallelujah. God is so good. Listen, we are so excited about our next. We're excited about what God is doing in this season.
Yes.
Listen, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to put your hands together for, hallelujah, our praise and worship leader here at One Touch Ministries. Hallelujah. Sister Evangelist Wendy Dela Cruz. God bless you.
Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah,
yes.
Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah,
yes.
Hallelujah.
He is moving, hallelujah. Praise
yes,
the Lord.
Is.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, we come before you, Lord. Hallelujah. We worship your name.
Yes,
hallelujah. Oh, because of who you are, Jesus.
Because of
Glory to God, Jesus.
Yes, God. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Yes, God. We worship you because of who you are. That's what I'm talking about. That is a moment right there where you should be getting yourself in order to worship God right where you are. Come on, let's begin to worship God right where you are. Yes, God. Oh, yeah. Because of who you are. That's it, God. Because of who you are, God. And because what you did not allow to happen.
Yes.
Right there. Because you did not allow what was supposed to happen. That right there should put you in a position to worship him. He held back the wolves. He stopped the accident. What was supposed to happen didn't happen. You were supposed to lose your life, but you didn't. Sister Wendy is a miracle child. He got mine. She said it this afternoon. She said, God, I thank you because I'm a miracle walking. Glory to God. He got. I said, God. She said, I'm a miracle walking. They told me I wasn't going to live past one day.
She can talk, she can sing, she got the mouth now.
thank him for every Sunday celebration service. Make sure you come join us. Hallelujah. Every Saturday at 6 o'clock p.m. for our empowerment night on Zoom. Make sure you join us for the prophetic smile. Every Thursday night at 8 o'clock p.m. My God, from Zion, I believe it's 8:30, not 8 o'clock. But all glory, you will be waiting. Make sure you join Minister Henry every Saturday at noon on YouTube. Now listen, let me tell you something. Give an information, getting ready to go up. I want you to give like never before. I want you to put a seed on the transformation. Put a seed down on the transformation. Because God said I'm doing a new thing. I'm excited about my next. Because I want to do something what? New. God bless you.
Come and give God the praise. Hallelujah! Glory to your name, God. You are worthy to be praised, and you're worthy to be worshipped. We thank you, God, for everything that you're doing. We thank you, God, for every seed that's being sown right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, we proclaim right now in the name of Jesus that healing and transformation come about right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, we speak the sevenfold blessings to the people of God right now. We speak blessings of health for you and your family. God can still heal them. We speak blessings of deliverance to any inhabitants that you maybe have in your life. God can still deliver you. We speak blessings of peace to your mind about anybody or anything that may be getting on your nerves or disturbing you today. I speak peace over it. I speak salvation to any friend or loved one that you've been praying for. God can save them. And I tell you to dance on it. Dance and he's about to save your brother. Dance and he's about to save your sister. Dance and he's about to save your daughter. Dance and he's about to... Every one of my family members is about to get saved. Hallelujah. I speak salvation to them right now. That the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ compels them to come right now in the name of Jesus. I see comfort to every person hurting, bereaved, lonely, or confused. I speak finances, debt cancel. Hey! I speak debt cancellation.
Yeah, yeah, come on!
I speak debt cancellation in the month of May.
Yeah!
God, I dare you put a praise on it. That God is going to cancel the debt this month. Prosperity and economic empowerment to all of God's children according to his riches and glory. And I speak anointing and promotion in your life to complete every assignment and to move forward in your God-given purpose. Now shout it with me. God is blessing me. Thank you so much for tuning in to One Touch Ministries. I am your senior pastor, Pastor Shelly E. Young. Hallelujah. And I'm here to tell you right now that God is doing a new
thing.
He's doing a new thing in this month of May. And I thank God that he's doing it. I think he just gave us a theme for the month of May. A new thing in the month.
Woo!
about to do a new thing in the month of May. Hallelujah. He said, I will make all things new. You better watch out. There's some new stuff that's happening. There's some new stuff that's happening. There's some new stuff that's happening. Hallelujah. Woo! Come on, I'm gonna give you guys just 60 more seconds to give him a praise, to give him a worship. Hallelujah.
Meshach and Abednego, that you refuse to serve my gods or to worship the golden statue I have set up. I will give you one more chance to bow down and worship the statue I made. When you hear the sound of the musical instruments. But if you refuse, you'll be thrown immediately into the blazing furnace. And then what God will be able to rescue you from my power? And Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego replied, Oh, Nebuchadnezzar, we do not need to defend ourselves before you. If we are thrown into the blazing furnace, the God whom we serve is able to save us, and he will rescue us from your power, your majesty. But even if, somebody say, even if he doesn't, we want to make it clear to you, your majesty, that we will never serve your gods or worship your golden statue you have set up. Father God, I thank you, Lord, for your word, God. Father God, I thank you, God, for what you're going to say in this place on today. Father God, I know that it's going to bless your people. But Father God, in order for it to bless your people, I pray, Lord, that I decrease and you increase on the inside of me. Now, may we be edified, may you be glorified, and may the devil be horrified. I want everybody to shout this, God is able. I want you to understand, I don't care what you're going through in your life right now, God is able to do exactly what he said he's going to do. And I believe in that right now, that you may be facing some trials and tribulations, you may be facing some circumstances, but I'm here to tell you today that God is able. Put it in the chat right now, say, God is able.
God is able.
God is able. Yes, he is. God is able. All right, let's go into the story right now. Now, this is the story about the three Hebrew boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And many of you already know the story that, as you can see here, there was a golden image that was set up that the king at the time said that you need to bow down and worship that image. All right. So we got these Jewish boys in here that said and refused to bow down. Now, let me give you just a little bit of history here for a quick second. Because if you look at the scriptures, watch this. I'm going back to verse 12. It says here, it says, but there are some Jews, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, whom you've put in charge of the province or the state of Babylon. A lot of people miss this, and I actually didn't think about it until I was reading and researching this the other day. I was like, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was in a place of power. They were in a place of authority. Ah. And so when you have a person, when you have people that are in places of authority, there's always going to be somebody who's going to challenge that authority. And so then we as believers, we have, number one, we have authority in God, but also when we walk the earth, we possess a certain amount of authority. God has told us that he has given us power over snakes and scorpions and everything else, all the creeping things that creepeth on the earth. And so the Bible tells us that we got dominion over the creeps.
Dominion over the creeps.
We got dominion over the creeps. And so here it is, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they're in a place of power. And now that since they're in a place of power, now they're being challenged. How
many of you have been in that place of power or a place of authority or in a certain place in your life or in your job or in your business or whatever the case may be that you get challenged? Mm-hmm. All right. And so this is what's going on here. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were in a place where they was ahead of the state, if you will, yeah, of Babylon. And so then you have these people that that was like, well, if everybody's supposed to obey this rule, how come these three ain't obeying this rule? So I begin to think about that because there are certain things that's happening in the world right now, not just in America, but in the world right now, that says that we have to be able to come under subjection of this whole thing of, oh, this gender thing, you know, you can't say him and her and she and they is what they identify as. You have to come under subjection. I'm going to say this. I'm going to say the fact that I'm going to respect your decision, but I'm also going to say that that's even not natural, because when you being born, a lot of people nowadays, now they ain't do this, as far as I know of, from the growing up, they do gender reveals.
Right.
Am I right? Yeah. They do gender reveals.
Right. And it's only two
genders. And it's only two genders.
Right.
I don't care what you identify as. I just want to let you know that you either a girl or a boy. But the world is trying to get our children, the world is trying to get us to come under this subjection of when you see and hear this, that you have to bow down. They want you to bow down to this image. Bow down to what they believe in. Bow down. And as I'm reading the scripture here, I'm like, the three Hebrew boys, they respected the fact that everybody else who wanted to worship that golden image, it was like, you go ahead and worship. Mm-hmm. But see, but the God that I serve won't allow me to be able to worship that image. I'm here to proclaim to you today that there are certain images. That God would not allow me as a man of God to bow down to.
Ooh, come on.
And I don't care what devil of hell and try to come up against this word on today, I'm letting you know right now, I'm not bowing down. Amen. The Bible says this, that they told, then they went and go tell the king, they went and rushed off and go tattletale on the three Hebrew boys and said, they pay no attention to you. They refuse to serve your gods and do not worship your image that you set up. So many people are going through identity crisis.
Yes, sir.
So many people are going through identity crisis. They don't know who they are in God. They don't know who they are as a person. They are messed up in their minds. And just a bit, and now I'm not talking about the gym thing. That I'm not just talking about that. I'm just talking about just people in general. They don't know who they is. They don't know, you know, themselves. They don't know what they like. They don't know who they like. They just don't know. So they're a little screwy in their head. And so I'm here to tell you today is that you have to understand that your image. So when you look at yourself in the mirror, not only can you say, I'm a child of God, that I'm created in his image, but I can look in the mirror and say, Shannon, you're a man. Shannon, you're a worthy man. Shannon, you are somebody that's worthy of good things. Shannon, I can look at myself in the mirror and say, I believe what God has called me to be. I believe what God says that I am.
Yes.
I believe I can do things that God says that I can do. The Bible tells us that we can do all things through Christ don't want you to suffer with identity crisis. I want you to know who you are. I want you to understand that there is a God that can change your life around. I want you to feel the fact that you don't have to bow down to, lustful things. You don't have to bow down and say, I'm that girl that twerks. I'm the person that drinks and smokes. You don't have to bow down
to
those images. You know, there's certain things that the world sets up that make you feel like that you have to bow down.
You're right, Pastor.
Then watch this. After the tattletale, they brought in the king. So got to understand this is that in the Bible here, King Nebuchadnezzar, not only were the three Hebrew boys were men in power, but they also had a personal relationship with the king. If you read earlier in chapters 1 and chapter 2, it talks about the relationship that they had with the king. See, I personally believe that this was something, although the king set it up, but there was something personally that was set up. See, because I believe that sometimes there are some people that's in your life that try to set you up for your fall. Sometimes people try to set you up for your demise. Sometimes people try to set you up to make sure that you go down a downward spiral.
Downward spiral, come on.
Some people want you, they want to see you
hit
rock bottom. They want to see you do it. A lot of times we say, oh, it's the devil. It's the devil. No, sometimes the devil works through people too.
Yes, it
is. And so we're living in a time that people will set you up to make you feel like that you're going heading down this downward spiral.
Yes, yes.
And then I also notice in the scripture that sometimes it's the people who's closest to you. What can hurt you the most in life than the people who's closest to you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because you wouldn't think that, oh my God, they wouldn't do this. Oh my God, they wouldn't say this. Oh my God, that it's the people that's closest to you. Sometimes that becomes a disappointment in your life.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of times we grow up with that disappointment and we never let it go.
Yes, yes.
I'm here to tell you today that through every disappointment, I want you guys to let it go today. Put it in high and say, let it go.
Let it go.
My God. Every disappointment today, I want you to let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every disappointment on today, because it's the person that was the closest to you. It's the person, it was that loved one. It was the husband. It was the wife. It was the mother. It was the father. It was the son. It was the daughter.
Every disappointment.
I'm here to say that you got to let it go today, because God is setting you up for something. And a lot of times we may not see it and we might not understand it, but I'm here to tell you that God is able. Well, I will give you one more chance, said the king, to worship the statue I made. And when you hear the sound of the music, I'm breaking some stuff here. I'm gonna just allow me to teach for a bit. Do you understand and realize that Satan was, well, Lucifer at the time, he was the angel in charge of the music in heaven.
Take your time, sir.
He was the minstrel. He was the minister of music in heaven. The Bible tells us and it teaches us that Lucifer had instruments in his body. He was a walking, moving, living, yes, breathing instrument of God.
Come on, come on.
And that it caused people and the angels to bow down and worship God. But what happened was that Satan wanted to get the worship for himself. So what ended up happening, reason why the enemy moves so strong through music is because for the simple fact that Lucifer was the minister of music. That's why he can creep in through the lyrics. That's why he can creep in through the beat. That's why sometimes you can listen to stuff, you say, oh, that's a good beat. But I want you to stop and listen to what they're saying sometimes. Because they're casting spells on your spirit to cause you to bow.
To cause, glory to God, yes, yes.
They're coming out with music and songs now. You don't know if it's heterosexual or homosexual. But you listen to it and it will cause you
to bow. Come on.
I'm here to tell you today, we need to take an example of the three Hebrew boys that hears to say that I refuse to bow down. I refuse to bow down. He said, I'm going to give you another chance. The enemy's giving people chance after chance to try to bow down and worship him and bow down to your mind, to bow down, to say, you know what? You might as well go ahead and off yourself, unalive yourself. Nobody cares about you. The enemy is giving you another chance. And so then if you begin to listen to the music, I'm here to tell you that you're going to bow.
That's it.
Down.
You
got to learn how to refuse,
yes,
to bow down. Check right me, Shaq and Abednego said, oh, King Nebuchadnezzar. He said that I don't have to defend myself. You have to understand that you have to be in a position that you so know yourself and God so much to the point that you say, you know what? I don't have to defend myself.
Come on, Pastor. That's it. That's it.
I don't have to defend myself. I know who I am in God.
Yes, God.
I know who I am in God.
Yes, God.
And it says, we do not need to defend ourselves before you.
Yes,
God. If you throw us into the furnace, the God that we serve,
yes, Lord,
is able. I'm here to tell you today, God is able.
He's able.
I don't care what the situation is or what the circumstance is, God is able.
God is able to move
for you on your behalf in your situation. God is able to do some great things for you, and he will move for you. I know that right now you may not feel like that God is doing nothing for you, but I'm telling you right now that God is moving on your behalf. I'm letting you know right now that God is able. He's doing some things for you. We just said today that God is about to save your family member. I want you to believe that he's going to do it. I want you to believe that right now in the name of Jesus, that God is going to open up some windows of heaven that you don't even have room enough to receive it. God is able. Come on, say it right now. God, he's able to give you exceedingly and abundantly of all that I can ever ask for. There's some things that I'm believing God for. There's some businesses that I'm believing God for. And I know for a matter of fact that God is going to do it to open up the windows of heaven, God, and begin to pour out blessings. Blessings upon me, God, because I know that you're able. I'm not going to bow down to the golden images. I know you're able. Throw me into the fire furnace right now. But I'm believing you will do it. And I know that I'm going to make it. Put it in the comments and say, I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it. I'm not going to be destroyed. I'm not going to be knocked out or chewed out.
know for a fact that God is doing it for me. And I'm not going to leave today not believing that he's not going to do it. Because I know that he is able. Say it, he's able. He's able. Yes, he is. He is able. They said, oh, King Nebuchadnezzar, I'm going to have to defend myself. A lot of you feel like that you got to defend your faith. God said you ain't got to defend it no more, because they're going to look that you're inside of the fiery furnace, and they're going to say, didn't Keisha go in there? Didn't Bob go in there? Didn't Peter go in there? But in the midst of the fire, there's some things that's troubling. And I know that they should have lost their mind right about now. But I'm here to tell you that we serve a God that cares. He is allowing you to be able to come out of darkness into his marvelous light. And I thank God for doing it. To the point that the king said, when there's 3 men inside of the fire, but I see a 4th man. I'm here to tell you today that there is a 4th man that's coming into your situation. God sent the Holy Ghost to be able to say, I'm here to deliver you. I'm here to bring you out. Oh, hallelujah. He said that I sent the paraclete to lead and guide you and direct you into all truth. I want you to know that God is able. Hallelujah. Through every situation and circumstance, God is able. Don't leave this place today and not believe that God is able to pay your bills. He can fix the mortgage. You may be 2 or 3 months behind, but God is able. You may be 4 months behind on a car payment, and they get ready to throw people in that sucker. But I'm here to tell you, God is able. Hallelujah. I know that rent is due on the first, but I'm here to tell you, God is able. To do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ever ask or think. You think that he just wants to pay your mortgage for the month, but he's trying to pay the whole house off. He's able. He's able. Come on, say he's able. He's able. He's able. He's able. Thank you, God, for being able. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for being able.
Thank you, God, for being able.
Thank you, God, for being able. Watch this. The king brought them out. And it says in verse 27, the high officers, the governors, and adversaries, the advisors, they crowded around them because they came out of the fire. I'm here to tell you today that you're getting ready to come out of the fire. You're coming out of fire as pure gold. Hallelujah. And it says that not a hair on their head was singed. It says that their clothes didn't even smell like smoke. I'm here to tell you today that although you may be going through some fiery times right now, God is saying that you're coming out and you're not going to smell like smoke. You're not going to smell like smoke. And then watch what Nebuchadnezzar did. He said, praise to the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Come on, the people that don't know God, they may not know your God. But they said, I'm going to serve the God of wind. I'm going to serve the God of Nebuchadnezzar. I'm going to serve the God of Shem. They might not know God as Yahweh, but I'm here to tell you that God is able. God's going to save your family. They're going to say, I want to serve the God that Shem serves. I want to serve the God that Henry serves. I want to serve the God that Capricia serves. There is a God that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ever ask or think. And then watch what the king did. Therefore, I make this decree that if any person, whosoever in their race, nation, or language speak a word against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they will burn, they will be torn limb from limb, and their house will be turned into a heap of rubble. And there is no other God that can rescue you from this. Then the king proclaimed Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego to even a higher place in Babylon. I'm here to tell you today that God is about to elevate you to a whole other place. And I want you to say, challenge my God. Somebody put in the comments and say, challenge my God. Because if you challenge my God, and when I know that he's able to do it, I'm here to let you know here today that if you come against my God, your house might end up in a heap of rubble. You can talk about me all you want to, but you better watch out because your house might end up in a heap of rubble. Just say it one more time, he's able.
Tuning in for
is able.
Yes, God is able.
Yes, God is able. Yes, God is able. Yes, God is able.
Power both now and forevermore. Church said amen.